India's most promising small and medium enterprises here with us. But first, I'd like to begin with you, Mr. Nagesh. You're someone who has strongly advocated the use of technology in business. You've literally turned Shoppers Stop around with the kind of, you know, innovative technologies that you've introduced. But as far as a small or a micro enterprise is concerned, how can it leverage technology without, you know, sort of pinching its pockets too much?
See, first of all, I think before you get into technology, the important part of technology is it is a tool used to amplify and replicate processes for scale up. Okay, that's the first important thing that I believe. And therefore, the first belief that you have to have is that are you willing to look at processes? So to me, the mindset has to be to say, if I have to grow, I need the right kind of scaling up mechanism. I need the right kind of processes. And once you know that the processes and the scaling up mechanism is available to you, by the technology, it helps you actually replicate. And I think that's the way that I would look at technology for a small enterprise. And then cost is not an issue at all, because today you get technology at 5,000, you get technology at 50,000, and also at 5 crores.
The other problem that SMEs constantly face is that of finding and retaining talent. Now, because let's face it, good talent does come at a price. So what's the way around that? Usually, a lot of them don't have a very structured organizational hierarchy in place. How can you retain and attract the best of the talent?
I think first of all, you have to sell your dreams to people. Don't forget that as much as you have dreams, the youngster, the employee also have dreams. I mean, 99% of the people don't take up a job because they want a job. Because if they want a job, they can be a coolie and they could be a murderer, they could be a housewife, they could be anything. The reason they want a job with you or looking at your sector is because they want to be part of your dream. So the first is, are you selling your dream to the individual? Second is, are you able to make him part of the ownership? And when I'm saying ownership, I don't mean shares. And how does ownership come? The first important thing of ownership is empowerment. If you are able to empower your people, they start feeling ki yaar ye mera hai. So the first way of attracting people is to get them part of your dream. The second way is to empower them. The third is, don't get them onto roles. Please make them part of your goals. Don't ask him to say, I want you to be my salesman. No. If you are selling water purifier, you have to say, I want to have 1,000 Indians to have pure drinking water. Can you be part of my journey? And treat them as one equal. I think that is very important. Very, very important.
What's your experience in this respect? Did you find it tough to initially attract talent?
I think everything that Mr. Nagesh said is what we were able to do. I think everybody was so attracted to internet as such. So everyone who came in essentially came in because they wanted to make something in this whole internet arena, which they found to be very, very interesting. One of the things that we did for every single hire was we spent about 2 hours with them, telling them how internet is going to change the whole world and why IndiaMART, which is going to use internet to change the lives of businesses, would become a lot more successful. So this is what we sold, and we got people to work for us at a variable salary way back in 96-97. And that is the most important part for us to hire talent.
And in fact, there's a whole new huge wave of young entrepreneurs, a lot of startups happening these days. Do you see that as India's advantage in the years ahead on the global arena? And what's your watch out tip for them?
The good part of this is that a lot of entrepreneurs are coming, but they're all coming in the internet and the service space.
Right.
You know, I mean, just if you take as an example, in retail, if you spend a crore, we create 100 jobs. In IT, if you spend a crore, you spend probably create 4 jobs or 5 jobs. So to me, the important thing is that the manufacturing sector, the small and medium enterprises, which are absolutely in the hinterlands, they have to also start looking at innovations and grow the business. Because what you can do, a service organization or an internet organization cannot do, and make this sector grow much more.
But in the current economic scenario, what's your one watch out tip for young startups?
One watch out tip is, I would say just be grounded and drive. Don't lose heart. Just drive.
You deal with a lot of youngsters, a lot of SMEs. What's your experience? What's their biggest challenge?
So my experience has been that entrepreneurship has always been there. It's been more talked about in the tech space today because of the venture capital financing being made available to them. But what has been strikingly painful to see is the scale that each of these entrepreneurs have been focused upon building. It has started with the technology sector, the IT companies, the internet companies today, wherein you would have entrepreneurs who will have dreams which are much larger. Everybody would want to become a Google or a Facebook of the world. So I would just say that if there are similar aspirations that we can build in traditional businesses, which would essentially operate all across the globe, all across India, we should be able to build similar large businesses. It's just the aspirations probably, and the method that you adopt to scale.
Right. The other big hurdle is that most of this sector is still very unorganized, and it is going to remain that way for some time to come. Do you see a method to the madness?
If you look at in the last 10 years, India has started celebrating almost every festival in a very big way. I mean, for some reason, every festival is becoming bigger and bigger and becoming more and more modern. I was thinking, why should the diyas and the battis and the ganeshas come from China? Today, if you look at it, all that Raksha Bandhan, Rakhis have started coming from China. Yeah. Okay, after all, there must be a cost of transportation. There must be something that they must be doing. Every time they say there's no subsidy, mil jata unko, but no, there must be something else that it must be doing. So somewhere we have to get into things, dirty our hands. There are dozens of opportunities which are there on the ground.
All right, we've completely run out of time, so we're going to proceed to the award ceremony. Thank you so much, both of you.